after, I don't know, several hours waiting for H1Z1 to get back up, and I said, fuck it. I'm fucking tilted.
These fucking cookies are the best. All right, Bron.
MVP showdown, boys. And here's the, let me pull up the image. OBS, 5. Oh, shit, yeah. Boom, 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 boom. The fuck is it? Where the fuck? Was shit lagging or what? The fuck? All right. We got a ringer? Yes, we got a ringer. Do we? Can't find anything, guys. Everything's fucking hidden. A D legend. Yo, inspirational Bo Dallas with the 9 motherfucking months. Appreciate that. Jesus Christ. Struggle's real, guys. I can never find anything. Why is that? Fuck. I will find this someday. One, two. The fuck. You think I might have the wrong overlay? Yeah, man, I can't find other ones. I had so many things open, man. Everything's so fucking misplaced because I want so many different overlays. I've been throwing them on my desktop, which is probably a bad idea. Lego! Alright, so where is my motherfucking... Alright, so... Boom, boom, boom. Alright, so it's gonna be silent support. Leon Patter, thank you for the 420.
Yo, break his arms, advice. This kid called cerebrally ganglia is holding me back from Challenger.
I know, man.
What should I do?
You gotta do something.
Boom, boom, boom. Alright, let's see. Right click.
Minions have spawned.
Boom. Fucking A.
I just checked the vents, it's not in there. It is not in there. Overlay. Overlay. I know. Events. The fuck? What am I saying? I'm looking for an overlay and I can't find it. What the fuck? Alright, fuck it. Alright, so let's see. We got Kench. Yo, Sid Rice. I don't know if he... I think he's a pleb that won MVP yesterday. Top lane Kench. And Ghost Casper is the one countering shit. No. It's this dude right here. Countering the Victor mid. And then we got Sion support with Kalista AD. Swain's gonna be top. And Shyvana in the jungle. That's gonna be what? Soraka as robot, Victor mid, and that's gonna be Zenny Zen. Boom. Alright. Alright, let's see, boom. Map overlay? No, I don't see that in there. Monitor 1, monitor 2. Alright, we got a Gankarino coming in. He's not playing Nocturne, I don't know if it was banned. And boom, we got the exhaust drop. What the fuck are you doing dropping the exhaust? Should've just flashed exhaust to Kalista. Boom. Alright, Ezreal's front line, and I don't think that's a good idea. Well, you got Ciroc in the back. What tank and mod? Let's see, what is this? I have that Sigeli 150 with the Klepto tank. Klepto! Alright, I got the curse for both teams. Let's go listen to team 2 real quick. Hold on, where's the link?
Trick's in here.
Trick's in here!
What's up, man?
Where's Shyvana at? Teleport top. Top teleport down.
Okay.
Trick's spying. Why is he doing this?
He's in our call?
Yeah, he's in our call. Yeah, can we get a TRK spy in chat?
Ghosted? Coming in.
Shyvana's mid.
There we go.
Good job.
Thank you.
Nice.
Good job, guys. All around.
Look at that shit, guys. Good job all the way around.
There's a peak here. My dead.
Yo, Wonderwise, man, relax, man. I'm not at 100%, I'm at like 20% right now.
Ari's rotating down, careful guys. You see her? She's rotating.
Alright, they're all coming here.
The bot is there too, there's three bot.
Yep. That's communication though, you gotta give it to him.
No, watch out.
Ari's here. Ari's there, pushing mid in.
Get out, okay. Oh god.
Yo, flash if you can.
I already flashed.
Oh, yeah, you did.
Wait. We knew they were coming by. How did that happen, guys?
We were moving back.
Damn.
Damn, she got there that quickly. Yo, Victor.
Yo. Yeah, she's in there.
Why is it so cringe, man? Bronze players, you know, this is what communication sounds like. Shouldn't it be bronze players trying to communicate, lol? So much spoilers, I mean, that's what it's all about. I mean, sometimes you gotta get an idea, man, what a game turns out to be when you get put, you know, you put these bronzies together.
Bigger bad than start coming top.
Trick share.
There are wards topside, going around the log way.
There's no ward.
Yo, can we catch her? Catch her? Pick her off?
Yo, Trick. When I try to breach gates, my teammates right, always get caught.
Splash down.
I tell them to stall while I split, but they're boosted animals and can't defend. Chat spam YDB for the bronzies.
Alright, well, fucking Shyvana's bot.
Top flash is down. Shyvana's bot.
Yo!
Go back soon, they're probably gonna set up drag soon.
Yeah.
Alright, so, the communication
they know
guys.
Top side too.
So they knew he was coming, he went over the ward, and wait, they were walking back way before.
No.
So,
yo, let me try to go back around again.
They might have put a ward in the bush when they were in there.
I don't know if they saw him there?
I don't recall seeing it. Coming in.
That's Ripperino.
Dangus. They banned his champ, so he changed roles and went to support. He was supposed
they're probably
to
doing
top.
Dragon.
Alright, let me mute this.
Should I ult it? No.
Alright, I'm gonna mute him real quick. This overlay fucking is the struggle. Overlays. Events. Halloween. Overlay. I don't know about all that. There we go. Alright. W. Alright, we in it, boys. We in it. Found it. Alright, I need to put bronze on this motherfucker. Attacks. T-E. What does this look like? Bronze alive now. Alright, so what I miss here? Alright, Sid Rice, he's got some MR. Swain winning in CS. Shyvana hasn't backed in a while. 1400 in the bank. 800. Victor 1100. No one cares about mid lane, actually. It really comes down to the bronze junglers. What can they do? Mid laners won't farm the best. 75, actually, that's not bad. Not bad. Nice. So if you max your W on, well, okay. If you're not getting a lot of ganks, then it's pointless to max your Q. I mean, look, that's what his Q just did to Swain. When you're better off maxing your W to get that next level wave clear. I mean, Swain is getting a free lane. You just got to make sure he's got to hit that last hit on every single minion. 69 to 51. Zinni Zen, if he doesn't go Strength of the Ages, you see this? That's no Strength of the Ages right there. So he's probably going to go Fervor. And if he doesn't buy Mercs, he's just going to die. He's going to get insta-get. But I'm pretty sure he's going to probably go... Well, I would rather go Blade the Rune King into a Cinder Hulk. Blade first, if you want to. So he does a little bit of damage, but he's going to need some CDR. But he can also get a Black Cleaver. And that's kind of obvious. And I don't know why this motherfucker's running into the bush just to see if somebody's coming. There's one lick. Okay, double lockdown. What up, babe? No. Well, I guess he's fine. Because he's only got one. Nope. Missed the slow. Well, will he flash in? A lot of minions being tanked. If he would have dropped. Oh, shit. We got something happening in the bot lane. There's a snipe. Yeah, man. I don't know why. Where the fuck was Beat Rice? He should have saved that shit. Unload the toad, indeed. And, let's see, boosted Zangoose. Shobo C, let's see. What is he playing? He's playing, what? Zangoose? He's playing support? What support is he playing? Oh, he's playing Sion. Okay, okay. This Kench is like Utrecht. You remember the game with Mike and Rabia? No, man, my Kench is broken. Why am I not playing in Bronze Suburbs? Varonovic, man, I'd put you down. Overextended with no flash. He's dead. Okay. Alright. I thought he was dead. Hmm. You win something 0-10, didn't you? We won that game, right? Pretty sure we won that game and I breached all the gates. I somewhat kind of remember that game. I remember I was playing top. Alright, the Sion build. Yeah, he's got his Targons and he went Swifties early. Now probably going for a Sight Sound to get some wards. Zen's got his Blood Razors, but if he runs into Shyvana, he will die instantly. Not instantly, but he won't be able to do enough damage unless he has some backup. Zen, Fervor, Blood Razors is not, it's good, but look at him. That's actually like four bars compared to what Shyvana's rocking because she's able to sit on top. Victor, meanwhile, 109 CS to 91 to Ari, mid lane. Ari got assist, and looks like Swain top finished Rotted Aegis. Spirit Visage first on Sid Rice. Sid Rice should have probably gone Rotted Aegis, too. That would have upped his sustain, plus gave him a lot of HP. Yeah, you right. You won the game. What are you talking about, Flocka? I won the game. Fails the spit. Spit not going to do a lot of damage here. See, that's what's going to happen right there. He's maxing his shield second. So he doesn't even care about fucking KS and kills. Like, that makes no sense. I mean, to me, I think wave clear is so much better. Like, what are you doing here? Okay. Walks in. Gets locked down. Alright. Spits him out. Look at this. No damage whatsoever. And he beat Rise like, what up? Alright, you probably want to get out of that. Now you're just going to go until you level up. And he is about to level up. He should have backed up. When you can't kill him like that and you can't calculate damage, didn't. Oh shit, Zen's gonna pick up that kill, but Zangu's gonna come in and drop that Q and pick up that kill, and that's gonna be the three champions sharing Zen, but Zen getting a solo kill. But Well, yeah, if you can't kill him, like, Swain should have backed off and saved some of his mana. You know, he's got to understand that he gets that free lane. He gets to chill. And if he gets ganked with no mana, then he dies. But Zane was bot side. I played versus full tank Jax jungle. It was what? Can't be that bad. Full tank Jax. It's, I mean, unless he goes 40% CDR, then he can sit on top of your fucking mid laner and just keep spamming fucking helicopter dick. Okay, blue gonna go over to Swain mid lane. I guess Ahri gets cocked out of that. All right, so the giveaway, if you see if it's up and running right now. Yo, here's the giveaway guy. Oh fuck, let me pause it real quick. Oh fuck. The giveaway, guys. All you have to do is go to and then monitor capture. If you go here, you scroll down, you'll see that giveaway at the bottom when you're on my curse. Just hit enter. You've entered. And when you first go to my channel, so when you click my channel right here, it'll pop up with the giveaway. But if it doesn't, just go to the bottom right hand. Just scroll down. As you can see, you can scroll down and you can enter right there. And you can see it's an international card, so that means you can use it anywhere. And back to the motherfucking game. And we got Zinni Zen ganking the bot lane. True Shot Barad's gonna follow up. Zangoose, no. Gonna have to back up. Did he have ult? Sion had ulti. Did he use it? Had exhaust. Didn't use it. So you could just tell these bronze players panic when people come to gank lane. Now, when Zen was going in, I think he got in the tower range, he would have exhausted, and the true shot might have probably been very close to killing Kalista. And plus, if Sion just hit R, that would have been a lot of damage being reduced, because Zen would have been oh no, you don't want to do that right there, young one. Alright, so the red team gonna slay the motherfucking dragon, and that's gonna be good for them. You have Victor mid now, chills. Okay, that's good for Kinch as he sits back and relax. Plus, he's about to get a Spirit Visage. That's gonna increase his healing. But overall, I feel like when you're going against Swain, picking up a MR item is all that's needed. Sion gonna use his ulti to get back in the lane to try to freeze the lane or actually take all the CS before it runs into the turret. Unmute the nuke. Permit the Kermit and defrog the Poliwag? Is that what it is? I can't see chat. Chat's fucking covered. A Poliwag. Okay, alright, alright. But yeah, he's playing the most boring fucking Kinch I have ever seen in my life. It's more like, hey man, come gank my lane. Or, hey fuck, I don't know what I'm doing. I'm just gonna max my fucking E second. Fuck your E, man. It's useless. Alright, Soraka will die here. No way she's gonna be able to. That's fucking 375 spears right through her, and she probably should have left that lane. So Kalista has Blaze Runekeeper. I haven't seen what happened to Kalista, guys. Is she not good anymore, or are we gonna wait until Worlds until somebody pulls it out? I don't understand, man. I understand they like Jhin because he sits back like a little pussy, auto attacks three things, and comes in and flashes on top of you and throws his fucking fourth shot onto you, or yeah, just snipes from the back lines. She's not good anymore. Okay, nicely done. You probably can't go on that. Turn. Yo, you're gonna save your boy. There's Shyvana coming in, and you see what I'm saying, how squishy he was, and they kept following up with that gank, and that's gonna be Sid and Zinni's in deep, and in deep knows that, you know, he knows about the build and what I think about that with Soraka dying, and boom, not out yet. Oh, there's the heal. Sion, boom, nice shred. Soraka, I think she had a heal and was hauling ass back the lane. We'll see what she's able to do here. So had exhaust. All right, Soraka pops her ulti, exhaust drop. Right there, Soraka fucks up by not flashing and exhausting. And Ezreal doesn't create any distance. And if he did, that means he's getting closer to Soraka. Plus, Soraka gets 6,000 movement speed. And First Blood Tower is going to go over to the blue team, which is really good for Swain. Could have gave it solo First Blood to Swain. You know, but me, I would have been like, yo, Swain, you can go back right now. I'll cover your lane when the tower's one hit. And I take the fuck. That's all it goes. Remember, whatever you can get, Soraka overextended. Ezra, what is he gonna do? He just got back in the lane, but Soraka, you know, not respecting his CC, and they're gonna continue to walk down. Shyvana coming down bot. Dragon is gonna be live in a bit. It's gonna be the Cloud Drake. Cloud Drake useless. 12-18, shut the fuck up. That fucking number. Uh-oh, look at the bait. Sion gonna pop his ulti. That's gonna be Zangu's tank in the turret. Boom. Okay. I forgot. You guys said she was fucking useless. There you go. How's that fucking useless when you got a knockup like that? How? Or an escape. Alright, Ghost Casper needs to think about not overextending so hard because you got Victor leaving mid to go. But Ahri, if she doesn't have to follow. I mean, if she doesn't follow, she can just push mid and bang on mid to get Zen over here, but she's going to be a little bit late. Swain, going to get laser beam, lockdown, not enough HP, and then get a wrench thrown at him. Ahri late to the party, and that's the thing, man. If you're not going to fucking be able to get anything, try to push this wave. Even though Zen would have been there, at least you're pushing something. And then after that, if the wave's big enough, if you're the mid laner or the jungler, you just cover top. But that's why you push your lane fast enough. So Victor leaves lane, fucking follow it, like instantly. If you don't, push the wave and then look to see if top is stacking hard enough where it's worth it for you to roam top to get the CS or make a play if they get really, really greedy and they're low and you know how to land abilities. Simple as that, right? Trick, nobody plays her beep high elo. She gets cocked. Yeah, does she? It's solo queue, man. It's solo queue. Calista's OP, man. I should show you my Calista. Get them spears. Alright, Shyvana could actually rotate down bot and just bait her bot lane into Zen coming in. It looks like they're gonna die. Zen gonna go in, Audacious, onto Calista, but Calista got the flash. Sion pops his ulti. I think he epically failed. Sion just trying to block some abilities. Boom, there's a nice ulti by Calista, and they're not able to catch up to that, and Shyvana gonna come in. Let's see if she drops or takes flight. Nope, should have taken flight onto Soraka, and then Calista could have, you know, did the peelage behind, but nope. Yo, Mr. Arbuckle, thank you for the subscriberino. Chaotic Bouncer, thank you for the 14 months. And Hardons, thank you for the 420. He says, yo, Trick, when I breach gates, my teammates always get caught. I tell them to stall while I split, but they're boosted animals and can't defend. Chat spam, YDB for the bronze. You see, that's not your teammates' fault, man. You know, when you play at that shitty-ass elo, I swear to God I hate this kid. Look at him struggle. Well, now he's building the Sunfire Cape. And he maxes his fucking stupid ass shield and his Q. It's like, why, man? Okay, Swain is definitely gonna die here. What? Alright, Ghost Casper gonna stand still, flash. Victor ends in, actually looping all the way around. Shyvana actually coming to back him up. Ahri push mid, so the wave runs up, and now you're gonna make him tank the turret. And that's the thing, man. It's common sense right there. Look at these two just loop all the way around, waste all that time. See, that's what, you know, I tell you guys, stay in your own fucking lane. Just stay in your own lane. When you don't stay in your own lane, and you decide to leave lane, you're wasting time. But then again, if you're playing against somebody that's holding you down and sustaining lane, then you just have to wait to a certain point where, you know, somebody makes a big mistake. But wasting time to go top like that, you know, it could cost you mid-tower. Now imagine if Ahri built a Lich Bane. GG. Bye, tower. Alright, Calista and Sion actually doing really well. I thought they were doing bad because of those Zen ganks, but it's just Soraka being so easy to fucking kill and overextended. And the lack of respect for that Quadra knockup. It's bullshit. Oh, good shit, man. You got that, Shyvana. You got that. Keep going, Shyvana. Look, oh my god, you did so much damage, Shyvana. Watch you use her ult. Yo, you guys owe me $5 for that. I call that shit. Whenever I call shit, you owe me $5, guys. I swear to God, man. I swear to God. You know, you gotta chill. You gotta understand that, you know, Kinch is pretty much unkillable. You know, if you need a void staff, then yeah, go for the void staff. But this is the biggest problem that I noticed, and it's hard to explain to you guys. Rift and chill. It's just too hard. It's like, you know, you really can't break it down. Even when I'm at, like, a loss for words, telling, like, the Swain, for instance, it's gonna be too hard to kill this dude, and if you do, you're gonna end up chasing him. Same thing for Zen and fucking, what do you call it? As you saw that the 1v2 turn with Chavanna coming in, well, a counter gank coming in because they overchased. You don't need to overchase and chase somebody down to the turret to try to get, you know, damage off. Just let it be. Let it be, man. And let it be is the hardest thing, and that's why I said it's so fucking hard. You know? Ugh, excuse me. Because, I mean, what are you supposed to do? Like, it's the 25-minute mark. Everybody, it still feels like it's in laning phase. Oh, my God. Chavanna, boom. We're going to get jumped on, but flashed out. Well, and then there you go. Look at that. Nice build there. He's building a giant's belt and picked up Mercs. It's still not enough, man. You do so much, you would have probably reduced the deaths you have right now if you went strength of the ages, because you would add the tenacity on the resolve page. But nope. It's always about getting to a certain point in this game by, you know, just farming it up and playing off the enemy team's decisions until you get good enough to make, you know, really, really good decisions without wasting a lot of time, because time management in this game is one of the most important things, and the one who gets that first and learns how to control the game on top of that becomes God. And then when you get your red buff stolen by a Swain and you don't prioritize your red buffs, and when your red buff spawns, you need to be on that motherfucker, boom. It just goes to show that, look, this guy is sitting here trying to make so many plays, trying to help his team. That's not what it's about, guys. It's not what it's about. You don't have a BRX in mid lane where, you know, that motherfucker is going to do his job. You don't have Faker mid. You don't have fucking Bang as your ADC. What we got is a bunch of bronze thrown-ass motherfuckers that will make a lot of boosted decisions. And somebody said, let's see. Yo, Trick, I need some advice. This kid, Karabe. And, oh, no, not that one. Which one was it? Yo, Trick, I sub. Okay, no. It was. Fuck. I don't know where it's at. Okay, we'll just use hard ons. He says, when I try to breach gates, my teammates always get caught. And I said this earlier about my teammates getting caught. And every single time, you have to be ready to breach instantly, man. Once they're about to get caught, 20 seconds, you know they're about to get caught, right? If they get caught, you gotta, you know, analyze the situation. If my teammate gets caught, what am I going to get for their deaths? What am I doing? Am I farming? Boom, we got something. What the fuck? He goes for the tower. Pump fake jukes, and he's going to get ulted for here. He's not going to get ulted, and we got a 1v2 situation for Victor. Victor going to drop that Cloud9, and he will go down instantly. And with top fighting right now, it's in top side. Chavanna not fucking pushing down mid right now, especially with, oh my God. And look how Zen gets baited in. See, in this situation right here, you got to let this, you know, Kinch, well, we'll wait for it. And there's a nice flash coming up from Ghost Cast. You gotta let him die. You just gotta let him die. It's not worth picking up that 300 gold. Okay, he's still left alive. And it's switching back. We gotta dive into bot lane. Soraka gonna get dropped. And boom, that's gonna be Ezreal next. And when you decide to help somebody top lane when it's already at a point where he's playing a champion where it's gonna be too hard to fucking kill the dude because, you know, he's just a fucking tank. Ignore that lane. Zen, protect mid. Zen doesn't protect mid. And then you analyze the Runes of Mastery, so you know he's not certain to the ages, so he's not scaling into somebody that's going to be able to, you know, carry the game 1v5. Because you always want to, you know, analyze, you know, every player in this game and what he means to his team. You know that, well, if you didn't have Ude on your team, you would have lost. Thank you, Ude. And that's what the fuck they do. They moan and groan. And that Zen, we're not seeing that from him. And when I see this Kinch, Max and fucking Q&E, what I see is, oh, fuck. He's thinking that, you know, the damage that Swain's going to be doing is a lot. So Max and E's just going to allow him to sit in lane. But what you're actually doing is allowing, you know, Swain to get a free pass to farm it up. And take it easy, because the damage you're going to be doing to him, it's going to take 670 fucking years, because you're going to be doing some dinosaur age damage. Damage over dinosaur. Damage per dinosaur ages. Where the fuck that, you know, BC, yeah, there we go. DPBC. Damage, there's damage per second, there's damage per BC. And that fucking takes ages, man. That takes ages. That's what the fuck this guy represents right here. Useless. Like, this right here might as well be a Nautilus. So, we already talked about Zen. And then Victor leaving lane because, you know, Swain's overextending. Like I said, you gotta hold your own mid turret. Doesn't hold his mid turret. Soraka, you know, Soraka's just a different case. Soraka just frontlining for some fucking reason instead of sitting back and get to a point where Ezreal can do damage. And that's how you would analyze this game. And if I'm one guy, I smoke this whole team. I roll them up in a big fat Optimo. Boom. Blunt. Done. Smoked. Now, I look at this enemy team, then I see that Shyvana's building Cinderhulk and builds the real fucking penetration, which is the Blade of the Rune King, rather than going Blood Razors. But going Blood Razors, you know, wouldn't have been bad, and then he would have went to tanky item instead of going to Blood Razor. But again, the Blood Razor means he gets to active with it, plus gets a little bit more movement speed, and has that, and he's 3-on-4, and is, you know, playing smoothly. And then bot lane, like I said, when you don't respect the fucking CC coming out, and you don't play back, this is what happened. Ezreal has to wait until he gets his Blade of the Rune King, a Last Whisper, then that's when he can carry the game. Because he's gonna have a useless, like, this guy's not, he's useless right now when it comes to 1v1. It's just, you know, damage per BC. But when it comes down to the team fight and all that stuff, GG. Yo, we got Ezreal, what up, baby? This is the Ezreal, Zen and Kench are duo, he won't gank for us, and is being toxic. I should be winning.
This is the Ezreal, Shin and Kench are duo, he won't gank for us and is being toxic. I should be winning lane hard.
Oh shit, damn, their whole team just left. Yo, what happened, guys? Sid Rise.
Yep.
Yo, what's happening? Where's your team at?
I don't really know.
They just
kind of hanging out up there.
Damn, man, they just straight up dips it on you guys.
Yeah, we were sitting mid for a long time.
So I heard that Zen's being toxic. Is that true?
I'd say no. Zen being toxic? No.
That's what the Ezreal. Okay, we got the squads coming.
What's up?
No, I'd say that's not true.
Yo, is this the rest of your team?
Yeah, we're here. We heard you.
So why the fuck did he come back in? Why'd you leave in the first place, guys?
We left because the game was over.
Don't spoil anything, guys.
I was still here. I'm still here.
So you guys didn't find a way to win this game?
We'll be spoiling it if we tell you.
I'm asking you, did you find a way? What was your way of winning this game? I'm asking you. It's already spoiled. We already...
Oh, no, we didn't win. We didn't
NA throws.
No, I'm not saying... No, you're not. I said you didn't find a way to win this game is what I'm saying. You understand what I'm...
No.
What was your way to win this game?
You're saying what would we do to
win?
Yeah,
what would you do to win this game?
Keep the lanes pushed. Keep the lanes pushed.
No, you were overextended most of the time.
Rotations.
Let's just say trick words. Split push. Gates. Deboosted. Right? Tilt? What? Right?
Where's the Zen at? Zen, you here?
Yeah.
What? Did you go fervor or something?
Yeah.
Why'd you go fervor?
I don't know. What fervor?
You know you don't need to. You can play it the same way you did Nocturne.
With Thunderlords?
Oh, you're running T-Lords? No, I don't know why you don't run Cinderhulk. Why don't you run Cinderhulk?
This game, the benefits of upgrading their trinkets.
I didn't run Cinderhulk this game, but the other games when I was the doctor, I was running Cinderhulk.
How come you didn't go Strength of the Aegis?
Well, with Strength of the Aegis, because I figured that, like, their team, like, pretty much outscaled our team anyway, so, like, I figured that we need, like, a... get a head start on them.
It's not a head start on them. See, the thing is, what you're missing is, when you go Strength of the Aegis, you're getting tankness. Not only that, later on, once you get the 30 stacks, that whenever you do a camp, if you're ever low, you're getting stacks back. But the HP is just, you know, it's like it's 300 HP. Go look at how much Giant Spell gives you. So it gives you 380 on a giant's belt. So once you get the 300 HP bonus from the strength of the ages, that mastery alone is worth close to 1,000 gold, right? And then what you decide to do is go fervor and fail to understand the situation. When you go fervor, it's like having a, this item right here. It's like having a blood razor. You understand that, right? Because you're going to be doing extra damage. Yeah. But the only problem is when you decide to go fervor and go blood razor, and then go mercs and giants, but you're not that tanky. You know, if you'd have went blood razors and strength of ages, that's a good combination into mercs and then into a chain vest and then Zangusa a black cleaver. Now you have
Zion carried me. Vote Zangoose for MVP, boys. He deserves this.
All right, hold on. All right, I'm gonna turn that off real quick, guys. All right. So yeah, pretty much you just made it easy. You cannot make mistakes, and you kept trying to gank lanes when you probably shouldn't have. I mean, if you're gonna gank mid, because I mean, look at Shyvana. Look at Shyvana today. She went Cinderhulk and then went Blade of the Rune King. You went Blade of the Rune King and fucking Blood Razors, and you went Fervor. And if I look at Shyvana's build, she went Strength of the Ages, so she outscales you. Like what Shyvana's able to do. What up?
Yeah, but I wanted to try to get us ahead. Ahead of time, because I didn't want it to go to late game, because with their team and their beefiness and their front line, like, I didn't really see us, like, being able to win, like, later on during the game.
You know, you could do the same thing with Strength of the Aegis and all that. You know, you could still do the same thing with Strength of the Aegis. What do you think I do with fucking Udyr and all that stuff? You think I just run fervor all the time? When I run fervor on the fucking God Deer, I make a lot of bad decisions, but I know what to do to, you know, get back into the game when it comes to breaching and when it comes to flaming. But when you watch me play, I go Strength of the Ages and I rush Frozen Heart first, and I'm sitting there with a fucking, there's Hunter's Machete and there's Talisman, the two items, and then it builds into a Stalkers or a Challenge, and that's what I do. I don't even finish Stalkers. I go straight into Frozen Heart. I think the last, I don't know how many games, I did it like fucking six times out of the last eight games I played Udyr. And you know what happens when I do that? I stay alive. It takes 9 fucking champions to kill me. You can do the same thing for Zen. You know, the longer you're able to stay alive, the less deaths, the less gray screens. You know, I got experience with the gray screen. I'm pretty sure you're bronze and you got experience with that. And then the Kinch, Kinch, you there?
Yep.
Why'd you max Q and then your fucking E first and second? Q first and then E second.
I just wanted to
pull
a little bit because he kept trying to get onto my turret.
He kept trying to get onto your... You know, if you max your W, and then you just buy a Spectral Cowl and then just go into Sunfire Cave after that, you'll be able to sit on top of Wave and push the Wave about 10 times faster than, you know, maxing your Q and E did. I mean, that's the struggle, right? That you struggled, right, underneath your turret?
Yeah.
So if you max your W, think about the damage you're going to do when you spit the minions out and you hit the back wave and the whole wave. You clear everything, and once you clear the wave, what does that mean? That there, you look at Sway and you're like, okay, you're not going to sit on top of him and just eat bee rice and play with this fucking bird, right? When you max your Q and E, and I said it, if you're listening, I was like, you're fucking useless. The only thing that you could look forward to is to peel for fucking Ezreal later on. And Soraka is just like, Soraka, you there? Hello?
Oh, yes, I'm right here. I'm here.
All right, so, yeah, I mean, you just frontline. You didn't respect the CC there. You didn't respect their CC. I mean, you know that's a knock-up, a ram, a slow, and then another knock-up from Kalista, a slow, spears, and then shred. You're fucking dead. Just like that.
I didn't respect it? How could I do that differently? What could have I...
Sit the fuck back. Sit the fuck back and just lose your turret if you have to. Just try to keep it up and heal Ezreal and let Ezreal scale and get to his 3 items and then the last whisper. He didn't get to his 3rd item. And then Victor.
What
Victor.
Did I do wrong?
What's up?
Oh, never mind. I was going to ask what I did wrong.
Ezreal?
Yeah.
No, you're chilling. I mean, the thing that you did wrong is you got to understand that your Kinch, what I explained, on and in your fucking Zen, you have to understand that these boosted-ass fucking animals are de-boosted, my bad, not boosted.
We're all shit.
Yeah, okay. So, yeah, you got to understand that his build is complete shit, and you're going to have to carry him. And then you got to also realize that Kinch's only job is going to help you out later on when he's the front line for you, and you're going to have to do all the DPS. And then Victor leaving lane should have never left lane to even help top lane. He should have just sat mid and never let his mid tower go down. And that's it. It's simple as that. And it's hard. You're probably like, oh my god, what the fuck, man? How are we supposed to do that? Because your whole team's probably tilted and doesn't know what the fuck to do when you don't understand the gates.
Yeah.
But when you understand all that and you realize they're fucking useless, then rip. And in Soraka, like I said, you know, struggles are real. That's going to happen to you once people, once those two champions get levels. If you're overextended, rip.
Yeah, I didn't mean to do that, though. I didn't mean to, you know, I went to the bush at one point, and Sion was there. You know, that scared me. That's a jump scare right there.
Well, no shit. And like, you're panicking, and you probably don't know what to fucking hit. You're probably fucking calling for your mom. You probably start lubing yourself and all that stuff, right?
Wait, Trick, can I address something that's going on in the chat right now?
Yeah, go ahead.
So somebody said that I'm the Ezreal, and I donated and said some shit about my team. I didn't say any shit about my team.
Okay.
By the way, he's not crying. That's just his voice. Relax, guys. Relax.
I'm not don't crying. Fuck with my
team. It's not. Don't fuck with my team, niggas.
All right, guys.
Man, this whole team's boosted, including me.
We're all bad.
All right,
it's
guys.
Okay. Take it easy. Thanks, Trick.
All right.
Thanks, Trick. Thank you, Trick. Thank you.
Good game. Yo.
Yo. Oh my god. Yes. It's the legend.
Zangoose fucking carried us. That support sign was ridiculous.
It was awesome.
Like, you guys said it carried you. What about the enemy team carrying you? You forget that.
Oh yeah. Oh yeah. Believe me. They sucked too, but. I mean, I sucked as well. Everyone here sucks. It's bronze, but some people suck less than others.
Hey, Trench.
What up?
Hello, it's Calista. I told you this is my first Subwars. You know, I have something popping up in here in a couple of seconds. Thank you, man. That was fun.
Yep. Oh, my God. Oh, my God. D-Ray, what the fuck, man? What the fuck?
Yeah, I saw that they were
what the fuck?
Banning out
Yo, thanks for my first like, Subwars. It was fun. You're the best. In,
and I'm going to do support Sion. And with the Calista pick...
I heard you. Yeah, I heard you. I came in here and... Yeah, I heard you say. I was like, hold on. I was actually laughing about it. I was like, hold on. Did you say this shit's over? They're like fucking playing a shitty ass support. But you had the Quadra Naka bot lane to rock. That's the thing, man. You gotta understand that when they don't respect, you know, your CC at that point in the game, and Zen did come down bot, and they had a couple successful ganks on you. That's right. But you know, Zen, his you gotta remember that, like Shyvana, for instance. You know he went fervor, right? And you know he was building Blood and then Blade, or he went Mercs and then Giant's Blood and then started a Blade of the Rune King? Did you know that?
Yeah, somebody in chat said...
That's pretty trash.
What,
yeah, somebody in chat said that I carried the game. I didn't, man. It was
Tyler, who's Tyler?
Me. That's me. What's up?
No. What'd you play?
Calista? Yeah. I don't really play that often. I mean,
you know, you gotta remember one thing, though. You see... Like, carry the game, like, you know, carry the game would have been like, oh, fuck. I would sit here and be like, this dude's a fucking monster. Carry the game is when your whole fucking team's boosted and you lug these motherfuckers in bronze across the fucking map. See, the thing is, you have to say it right now. You know, until you get out of fucking bronze and show me the ways, ain't nobody on this team fucking carry shit. The enemy team carry you. Because right now, you know, you might be like, oh, shit, man, they're so wet. No. Zangoose, you're fucking boosted. You lost to the pledge yesterday, so don't fucking talk. You just gotta understand. Look at Shyvana, 5-0-5. When your jungler does that well, and he goes fucking Strength of the Ages into a fucking Cinder Hulk, he's gonna be unkillable. When fucking Zen goes Fervor, Blood Razors, and then decides to start building a fucking Blade of the Rune King, it makes the game easier for you guys.
Yeah.
It only takes one mistake, and then boom, he loses so much. That's the shit you have to
admit, I did do a lot of my job and peeled for my carry.
I mean, Zangoose, you really need to get out of bronze. I will have to say that. You do not deserve bronze.
I really do need
Washer, that. Washer. I know you're probably going to meet up with Sam B. Sam B's going to be waiting for you at the bronze one gates into the silver. He's going to put you down.
All right.
No, but let me...
I mean, he puts me down all the time, obviously. I mean, what happens is late game, though. Late game, he just cannot go for late game. Early game, he fucking kills me. That's a fact. Fucking fact. Late game, well, let's see what happens.
Alright, I think that's about it.
Wait, Trick.
What up?
For top, I was Swain. Like, what could I do different to improve?
Don't ever play Swain in bronze again.
Good point. Good point.
What could I work on for my jungle?
No. Seriously, if you do, just work on your CS and your and just, of course, when you're about to get ganked, learn how to 1v2. Learn how to 1v2 the enemy jungler. And then what do you call it? You know how they came to gank you and you were able to turn on him? Like, you gotta realize that you could have turned. You turned a little bit late and you had to flash in. That moment right there when they're walking into your wave, you should have been like, you dumb motherfucker. So learn that 1v2. Like, when I play top, like, when I go top with Ignite, I say, look, bitches, I don't give a fuck if I die. I'm here to fight both of you. And that's what you look forward to do in top lane as you're trying to climb out of bronze to silver. But you got, the first step is CSing really good, controlling waves. And just, you know, Swain's just a hard champion to last hit with.
Yeah. All right. Well, Trick, thanks for letting me participate in your Subwars.
Yep, yep, man. Fun. Yo, good game, guys.
Right. Yo, enjoy that $50.
Hey, who won MVP? Who won MVP?
Zangoose won MVP. Sure.
Zangoose? Oh, Zangoose, you might, what do you call it? Win a, what do you call that? A trophy. Get the legendary. All right, guys, you guys have a good day.
I'm not lying.
All right, guys. You know, that's just the way of bronze, man. You know, you gotta speak the truth. You gotta understand that, you know, there ain't no carrying. Enemy team carries you. The guy that makes the biggest boosted decision carries you. One guy, when you're one fucking guy and everyone's fucking negative, it's like when me and Chris at the start of the season were playing and the score is fucking 10 to fucking 40. But what do we carry with the gates? We're down 3 inhibitors, we're down 2 inhibitors, and we still win the games. And we won like 90% of the games. That's why everything got nerfed at the beginning of the season. It was because of that. Because people are really bad. And that was at the fucking, you know, the diamond elos. And that's how it was really, really, really bad. Really, really, really bad. I mean, everybody did the bronze effect. The bronze effect is when they just auto rush down mid. That's what we like to call the struggle. So can we get a TRK YDB in the chat for all you boosted ass?